Thank you, Rekha, for inviting me here. Thank you, Mohan, for this enlightening speech. Clearly, the world disruption has been amplified in so many ways in today's conversation. You know, when Supriya and Sanyal were talking to all of you, it is very, very evident that during all the conversations that transparency and you wanted to be involved. I mean, just the banking example, I mean, my mind was racing that both Mohan and I, who represent at least the technology sector, Mohan now represents the startups, what could we have done to avoid this kind of disruption in the normal banking? Ultimately, whether the amount involved was 1,000 crores or 2,000 crores, I mean, it was a substantial money. You know, when many of us spend 100 rupees, we get a notification by the banker because we charge that money on the credit card. Now, the mind that was going, mind is racing ahead to find out, is there artificial boundaries being created? You know, when Mohan started giving this example of asset light Uber, to me, it is also, there was an asset which was available which wanted to work only 3 hours. I mean, it was just not that automobile which was not being used. It was people who wanted to work 2 hours. There was a student, there was a housewife, there was probably a guy who wanted to make an extra money, or there was somebody who wanted to make driving a profession, but till he got proper, you know, regulator approval, he couldn't make it. Now here came an opportunity to disintermediate. The examples, you know, when Mohan was talking through the history, my word actually goes back into the mythology. I mean, everybody, almost everybody here is an Indian, and we know that we believe in that Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. The Trinity, Brahma the creator, Vishnu the sustenance, and Mahesh or Shiva being the destroyer. Now the question coming to my mind was that Mohan has established that disruption is inevitable. He took us through almost every industry to say the world is not going to be the same. Now question is, who is going to be the creator? Will it be the millennials? Will it be the startups? Or will it be some of the larger companies reinventing themselves? Now then, what is the role of the disruptor? What is the role of that Vishnu as a sustenance man? Or are these roles overstated? Maybe these roles don't exist anymore. Maybe if I take Tech Mahindra as an example, I mean, I would strongly go back after this presentation to tell my board that you should actually collapse all the three roles. Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, collapse all the three roles. Look at it from a different perspective. The founders were the creators. The CEO becomes the sustenance guy. The destroyer is the guy sitting next door who wants to disrupt me. Is it not happening in every industry? So now I'm saying, tell the board that, guys, let's flip all the presentations. My quarterly report typically talks about growth, profitability, you know, whether I spend that 2% for community services or not, what is the impact on the brand. I mean, you know the normal 8 items that every board measures you at. Now I'm saying, let's flip it, because we want to be the winner in this age of disruption. We want to first put a first slide should be, who can disrupt us? Is it a fair way of you know, merging the roles? Number two is, what will we create that will disrupt others? And then we come to the normal sustenance kind of a business. And I think if we follow that habit, and it doesn't matter, I know Sanyal has left, whether we do it in the government, whether we do it as an individual, I think we will remain relevant. Maybe we'll not only remain relevant, as the topic says, we will become the winners. And go through your own example. The world's wealthiest man is Jeff Bezos. What is he? Is he the destroyer? I mean, the world probably, I mean, by the time another decade goes through, and if Jeff Bezos remains on his path, I think the destroyer word will be replaced by Amazonify. I mean, think about it. The books business, the food business, the retail business, the healthcare business to some extent, and now eventually if he chooses to enter banking. And what is he doing differently? Ultimately, he's finding the inefficiencies of others. To me, the businesses have always existed. People give Airbnb example, but to me, it is that business has existed for 100 years. People have rented their flats, houses. People have continuously given away their assets on a weekly basis, on a daily basis. For some of us who belong to Delhi, we even remember that the government had a scheme during the Asian Games that we don't have enough hotel rooms. Atithi Devo Bhava, please become the host and allow the guests to come and stay in your houses. Now, was that called Airbnb? So the point again is that it is like Mohan took us through the history. The history has not only examples, but practices that some of us choose to ignore. A Nokia ignored a touch phone. A BlackBerry ignored a touch phone. Somebody took an opportunity and made a business out of it. So we can go through all the examples. Ultimately, the world will become is, one is, we have to look at the only critical asset in this whole equation, which is people. Now the question for all of us is, how to make people ready to allow not to be disrupted, but they become the disruptors? And how do we get down to a level where it is not one company or 10 companies, but where it is many companies? And I somehow love the example that Mohan gave of Saudi Arabia. They have come up with a vision statement called 2030. You know, when Mohan talked about Prince Salman, I mean, the reality is that he is the challenger. He is the ruler, and he is the challenger. Now, if that man is challenging the whole of Saudi Arabia to move away from oil-based economy to an alternate energy-based economy, I think he is showing a determination. And the number two part, I think, which is where many of us, and we don't read about it because I'm sure it is being discussed in the boardrooms, it is not actually becoming evident. Why? Because it is the future strategy of the company. Like, for example, if I am the Tech Mahindra CEO, I'm not going to tell you, I will give you all the data that an analyst will ask me, what is your digital revenue, what is your automation revenue, what is your blockchain revenue, but I'm not going to tell you what is TechM next. Now, and the TechM next means, or individual next means, or a Mohan next means is that I am not chasing the ball. I know where the ball will land, and I want to be prepared so that I can score the goal. Now, if that is the way we are going to work, I think we are going to be in a very bad, good shape. So just to take an energy example that Mohan spoke about, fracking, the shale oil, and the overall oil trends, and maybe if Mohan was in a good mood, he would have probably told you that the oil will be cheaper than water. At least cheaper than the bottled water. Right? So, and think about it, how much you pay for your bottled water, and think about what the oil price would be, and you would realize it won't be too far away. Now, that is anticipating. Now, if you're anticipating, then you're also saying, where is the other cost? Mohan talked about a lot about the fossil fuel. I mean, he talked about coal in UK. And remember when Margaret Thatcher, you know, took the unions, I mean, the coal industry was the one which was the biggest, you know, the pain in the whole economy. Now we are talking about coal not required. It happened in the lifetime of most of us sitting here. Now think about it. All of us generate waste. Our animals generate waste. In a small community, if we are able to convert waste to energy in a more efficient way, in a more compact way, and we are able to consume it on our own, I mean, it has become a microgrid as a service. That means we don't need power transmission also. It is not only about the fossil fuel. We don't need a power generator. We don't even need an electricity board if we are able to generate our own fuel. Do you think it is an impossible situation? And it is happening. Think about, you know, to me, the biggest destroyer is not Lord Shiva. To me, the biggest destroyer is a guy called Elon Musk. And why? You just saw what he is doing. I mean, you saw Tesla as an example. You saw that he finally sent a spaceship. You know what he did to the finance industry when he did PayPal. You know what he is doing with this, you know, this tunnel, being able to, you know, travel in a capsule. He will destroy the airline industry. Now, think about it, him as a genius. He's saying a car battery that he is using in a Tesla, during the day will run, during the night they will power the fuel at your house. I mean, he created a $1 billion industry out of solar panels or the solar cells. But think about it. There is a power storage which is sitting in your car. When it is not being used, why it cannot be used to power your house? I mean, we have only looked at it one point of view, na? Think about the solar panel continuously charging. Think about a solar panel. We suddenly solved the problem of storage of power. I mean, today we assume solar power is only available when the temperature outside is 30 or 36 or 42. So I can only request all of you is, first, play the role of Brahma, Vishnu, and Mahesh in your own lives. And if you do it, and if you become relevant, and if you become the challenger, and if you become the Elon Musk, the rest of the, whether it is the organizations, whether it is the countries, or whether it is our impact on the rest of the world, we will come out as winners. But we have to start with ourselves. Most of us have the answers. We chose to become the rule robots. Robots have been created by us. Let's not worry about artificial intelligence. Let's worry about enhanced intelligence. Let's use that extra intelligence that we all have. I know that Mr. President has already been looking at his watch, so I'm going to again request everybody that the Trinity or the three lords that we all follow by worshipping in different formats in Hindu mythology, there is a message there, and if we follow it, I mean, and if we merge those roles, if we interchange those roles, I think that is our winning strategy, and we need to start with ourselves. So I'm going to say thank you, guys, and thank you so much.